So yesterday, Melania Trump absolutely humiliated her husband, Donald Trump, based on what she said and how she said it, but also on what she hasn't been talking about, what she's been ignoring since her husband lost the election, since January 6th, since he left office. And so yesterday, a presidential historian tweeted out pictures of the Melania Trump Rose Garden from a year ago where she made the changes at the White House and said that she ruined the garden. And then Melania, through an official account, took great offense to this, saying it was misleading. The garden now has rose blooms and flower blooms that it didn't last year. And this guy should be ashamed of himself and he should never be seen as a historian. And look, a lot of people are actually talking about this as if the garden matters. And I just gotta be honest, I don't care. I understand that some people like the garden. Some people have this connection to it because it goes back to the Kennedy era and it's connected to Jackie Kennedy and all of that. I understand, but I truly don't care. Why this matters is that Melania Trump has been doing nothing. She has literally been doing nothing at all, saying nothing at all, giving opinions about nothing at all until somebody said something mean about her garden or somebody said something that she didn't like about her garden. And then she makes this big official angry whiny crybaby statement. And it's like, where were you for all of the actual crises? Where were you as your own husband and your children-in-law are criminal monsters going all across the country spreading lies and misinformation and disinformation? Where are you on that? Where are you on all the big kind of social and charitable issues that a lot of first ladies give a lot of time to when they were first lady, but also often after they leave office? Like, you're doing nothing. Like, you chill at Mar-a-Lago or wherever you are when you're not at Mar-a-Lago getting spa treatments. You don't really live with your husband. A lot of reporters are saying it's an open secret that Trump and Melania are rarely together, but no one talks about it. And so you have a ton of free time and you spend it talking on this. And that's why it's humiliating to Donald Trump, and that's why it's an indictment of Melania, because she has not defended her husband. She hasn't really spoken positively about her husband. She hasn't been alongside her husband as he's sort of resumed his 2024 run. He hasn't announced it yet, but we all know he's running. She's not at the rallies. She's not seen with him at these big events. She's never there, but she does have time, folks, to complain about people's complaints about the rose garden in the house she no longer lives in, right? This has to be humiliating to Donald Trump. You might play devil's advocate and saying she's sparing her husband because she doesn't want to criticize her husband, but she doesn't defend him either. Donald Trump gets hammered by people like me and everyone else every single day, rightfully so. But like, you know, if his wife was there for him, you would hear her defending her husband. When there were rumors about her not really loving him, she would come out and quell those rumors. And she hasn't been. And so when there are open Gossip Girl style secrets about their marriage, she stays silent because she knows they're true or doesn't care to address them. But the rose garden matters. Ultimately, she cares more about the garden and her reputation as a gardener setter-upper, than she does about the image of her own husband. That's why this is humiliating to Donald Trump. And that's why this is yet another sign that these people don't love and care about one another. They care about their own images and the transactions between them.